All right, so here's the video that I promised you. This would be for programming a digit 3 to trigger Spotify on an Android device. I set everything up to basically mimic exactly what you were seeing on your end. And I'm gonna walk you through every step so that way you can just follow this video. And if you follow every step, you should be able to get things working the way you asked. I did write down what triggers the program. So this is what triggers Spotify for Android. That may or may not make sense to you, but I did write that out just in case you wanted to see it. So anyway, when you called in, you were paired to your Android device. So what we're going to do is we're going to unpair, okay? And these are the steps to go unpair. So here's our device. We're going to hit the little settings gear wheel. Choose to unpair. Once you've unpaired, you're going to go ahead and move over to your Apple device. As I was saying before, programming on an Apple device is way easier. We're only going to use the Apple device to do the programming, then we'll go back to the Android where you'll trigger Spotify as you asked. So first thing you're going to do on the Apple device is pair. Okay, so here's your digit 3. Choose it to pair. Once you're paired, you're going to open our app called AirTurn Manager. If you have to download it, that's fine, but once it's downloaded, you're going to open it. Choose your device in the upper left-hand corner. We're going to choose Button Actions, and we're going to be programming Mode 5 to trigger your Spotify. So we're going to choose Mode 5. Then we're going to choose one at a time the buttons and program them accordingly. So we're going to start with Button Up. And you wanted that just means the up arrow, up button on the remote. So you wanted that one to be volume up. So what we're going to do is after you choose button up, you're going to scroll down a little. You're going to, under the section titled item 1, you're going to tap on type. You're going to choose consumer. Hit the back button once. This is the same section. So in the section titled item 1, it's going to say consumer. Now you choose consumer code. And for the up arrow, you wanted volume up. So that's volume increment. Once you choose that, you can hit the back button to get back to your programming screen. You'll scroll up. We're going to choose the next button, the left. You said you wanted, and that is just the left arrow, left button. You said that you wanted that to be previous track. So what we're going to do a little bit different is you'll scroll down a little. In this section, you're going to choose combination. Underneath that, in the section titled item 1, you're going to choose the type as keyboard. Button once. This is back to our programming screen, so you can see the changes as we go. Combinations checked. Type is keyboard. Now you're going to choose modifier. You're going to choose left control. Hit back once. Still back to our programming screen. Like I said, you can see these things fill in. So now combinations checked. Type is keyboard. Modifier is control that we just chose. And the keyboard code is going to be left arrow. So we need to scroll down and find left arrow. So it's spelled out, it's not a symbol, and you'll choose left arrow. Then you'll hit the back button to get back to our programming screen. Scroll up to the top, and you'll notice as we make changes, you'll get a red dot above the button indicating a change, okay? So now we're going to choose down. You said, once again, just down arrow, down button. You said you wanted down to be volume down. So we're going to come back down in this menu. You're going to leave the sequence type alone. In the section titled item one, you're going to choose type. You're going to choose consumer. Hit the back button once to get back to our programming screen. Once again, you'll see things change as we choose them. This stays a sequence. In the section titled item one, we now have consumer as the type. You're going to tap on consumer code. You're going to choose volume decrement. That means volume down. Once you have that chosen, hit the back arrow to get back to our programming screen. You'll scroll back up to the top. You see now we got a red dot above the down. Okay, so now keep going. You'll choose right. And you said for the right button, right arrow on the remote, you wanted next track. So we're gonna have to make some changes here again. This time we are gonna change the sequence type to combination. In the section titled item one, you're gonna change the type to keyboard. Hit the back button once. You'll see these things change as we go. So now it'll say combination, type keyboard. You're gonna choose modifier, left control. Once you have that checked, you'll hit the back button once. This is our programming screen again. You'll see all these things changing. So combination is chosen, type, keyboard, modifier, control, keyboard code is going to be right arrow. Once you have right arrow chosen, you'll hit the back button. This is back to our programming screen. You'll see now we have dots over almost everything. We have one more button to program, so that is the enter. So you'll choose that. You'll come down in the menu. You're going to leave sequence type alone on this one. In the section titled item one, you're going to, sorry, I did that a little quick. In the section titled item one, you're going to tap on where it says type consumer. You're going to change that to keyboard. You'll hit the back button, programming screen. Once again, you'll see things kind of change as we choose them. Stays sequence. In the section titled item one, now it says keyboard. You're going to leave the modifier alone to say none, but you're going to choose keyboard code and you're going to choose spacebar. Once you have spacebar chosen, you're going to hit the back button, get back to our programming screen. You'll now notice there's a red dot above everything, which means we've programmed every one of those buttons. You hit the back button one time. Don't go back any further or else you will delete things and you'd have to go back through the video and watch it and try it again, but you will hit save to error turn to save the changes that we just did. So that is the programming. That's done. We've done it on the Apple device. We are done with it. You can just go into settings, tap on the little blue eye, forget the device. You are now unpaired, and now we can move back to our Android device, right? And let's go ahead and choose the digits. We're going to pair to your Android device because that's what you wanted to trigger. You wanted to trigger Spotify on this. So we'll choose to pair. Okay, so now we're paired. We'll get out of here. We'll open up Spotify. Okay. And I kind of already had things ready to go. Bear with me here. It's triggering my podcast. Bear with me just a moment. You have to get into a playlist, and I don't use Spotify often, so just bear with me on this part. But essentially, it's programmed. It's ready to do what you want. You know how to use Spotify. You can probably just get in there and start using it. Let's see. And this part was kind of odd. So the play pause, I remember I had to do something kind of interesting to get it to trigger. I can't remember what it was. Bear with me. You had it working automatically. I'm just going to skip that part. But the middle button should be triggering your play pause. Like I said, you had that working. Shouldn't be a problem. On my Spotify, I had to be in a certain spot, and it started the song, and then once you triggered it once, then it would play pause, play pause, play pause. Everything was fine. Let's see. Okay. So the up and down buttons were volume. You can see my up button, up volume, down button, down volume. You'll see back button goes backwards songs. Oh, and of course I get an ad. I don't believe I have the pay for version, so I have to wait for these sometimes. If you listen carefully, you'll hear. Oh, come on. Sorry about this. Once you learn to listen for them, you'll catch yourself on the blog. Bloomberg.com. Context changes everything. Oh boy. I guess every town has a gonna restart Spotify. Okay, so let me show you this again. Up button is volume up, down button is volume down. I'll just start the song again. So up button, volume up, down button, volume down, left button, previous song, you can see it moving up my list, right one, next song, you can see it moving down, middle button is play pause. So that is how you program. That was each step. You should be able to follow this video step by step and do your programming, and everything should work properly. So go ahead and follow those steps, and let me know if you have any other questions. Thank you. Bye.